Hi student, today I am going to the class 6 reasoning chapter 10 exercise 10.1. So I am going to the question number 1 that is given that area of a right angle triangle is 144 cm square and its base is given 12 cm and we have to find out the perpendicular of the triangle. So here formula of the area of the triangle is given 1 into 1 by 2 into base into perpendicular. So here we will place the values. Area is given 144, that is equals to half into 12, that is the base, and into P, that is perpendicular. So after solving, we are getting that P is equals to 144 upon 6, that is equals to 24. So correct option is B, 24 centimeter. Now we are going to the question number 2. Similar question, here formula for the area of equilateral triangle is given that root 3 upon 4 into side square. So we have to place the value of side, so it becomes root 3 upon 4 into 4 into 4. So 4 is cancelled, now here we will get that 4 root 3, that will be the value. So correct option is C. Now going to the question number 3. Here the area of equilateral triangle again, that is given root 3 upon 4 into side square. Here area is already given, that is root 3. And after placing this value, root 3 is equals to 3 upon 4 into side square. So side square becomes 4 root 3 upon root 3. Root 3, root 3 cancelled. So side square becomes 4. So after taking the square root, we will get that side is equals to the 2 centimeter. So here we have to find out the perimeter. Perimeter of the equilateral triangle will be 3 into sides. So 3 into 2 equals to the 6 centimeters. So correct option is B. Now in the question number 4, the perimeter of isosceles triangle is given and the one of the equal side is given and we have to find out the smallest side. So simply we have to write down the formula for the perimeter. That is given 30 cm and one equal side is given 12 cm. As we know that formula is that P is equals to sum of the sides. So placing the value of P, that is 30, equals to the sum of the sides. Two sides are same, so given 12 plus 12 and third side is X. So we will get the value of X is equals to the 30 minus 24. So here we will get the value of X is, that is 6 cm. So option B is correct. Now dear students, I am going to the question number 5. The perimeter is given sum of all sides. That is the formula. So here figure is given. According to the figure, P is equals to the 5 plus 2 plus 2 plus 1 plus 7 plus 3. So after adding, we will get that 20 cm. So option C is correct. Now my dear student, I am going to the question number 6. Whatever the figure is given in your book, here we have to find out the perimeter. So perimeter will be the sum of all the sides and sides are already given. So we have to find out all the sum. So that we are getting 12 cm. So option B is correct here. Now my dear student, I am going to the question number 7. Here perimeter is given 56 cm and length of the one side is given 15.5 cm. So as we know that the perimeter of the rectangle will be 2 plus 2 in bracket L plus B. So after placing value, P is 56 and 2 as it is in bracket, L is given 15.5 cm and plus B written as it is. So after solving, 56 upon 2 equals to the 15.5 plus B, and now the left hand side value becomes 28 is equals to the 15.5 plus B. So B will be the 28 minus 15.5, that is equals to the 12.5 cm. So option B is correct. Now in the question number 8, it is given that area of the square is given 81 cm square. As we know the formula that area is equals to the side into side. So after placing value, 81 is equals to the 9 into 9. So finally the side becomes the 9 cm. Now we have to find out the perimeter. So perimeter will be the 4 into side, that means 4 into 9. So that will be the 36 cm. So that will be the correct answer. Now in the question number 9, we have to find out the area ABED. So for this, we have to find out the area of ABCD, that is the square, plus we have to find out the area of the BCE, that is a right angled triangle. So for you know the formula for the square, that is side into side, and for the triangle, that will be the half into base into height. So after placing the value 6 into 6 plus half into 4 into 6. 6 into 6 becomes 36 and half into 4 into 6 becomes 12. So now 48 centimeter square will be the correct answer. So option C is correct. Now going to the question number 10. Here question is given that if the side of a square is doubled, what will be its area? So simply if we are going to double the side, then what we will get? That area will be the 2x. First area will be the x into x, means x square. After doubling, area will be the 2x into 2x, that means 4x square. So 4 into old area. So that area becomes 4 times of the older area. So option C is correct. Now finally, I am going to the question number 1 of the exercise 10.2. Here first question is given that we have to find out the area of the given triangle. So this is given an scalene triangle. So formula for the scalene triangle is equals to the under root S into S minus A, S minus B, S minus C, where S is A plus B, that means sum of the side divided by 2. So sum will be the 6 plus 8 plus 4, these are the sides are given. Sum will be 18 divided by 2, it becomes 9. After placing the value in under root 9 and in bracket 9 minus 6, 9 minus 8, 9 minus 4. So finally we will get that in under root 9 into 3 into 1 into 5. After solving this, 9 can be written as 3 into 3. So it becomes 3 square. So we have to take it out from the root. So final answer will be the 3 under root 15 centimeter square. So option C is correct. Now the second question is given, that figure given in your book, and here question is asking that the name of the AB that is given in the circle. So simply you know that AB is a chord. So option A is correct. Now I'm going to the question number 3. If the length and width of a rectangle are in the ratio 4:3, an area of the rectangle is 108 centimeter square. Calculate the length of the rectangle. So simply what we have to do here, area of the L and B, that means length and breadth, is given 4:3. So let L is 4x, B is 3x. Then area will be L into B, means 4x into 3x. So it becomes 12x square. Area is already given. So 108 is equals to the 12x square. After solving, we will get x square is equals to 9. So x is equals to 3. So the length will be 4 into 3 because the length is given 4x. So 4 into 3 means 12 centimeter. So option D is correct. Now going to the question number 4. In the question number 4, what is the perimeter of the given triangle ABC? So here we are watching that here two angles are given 60-60. So simply third angle also will be the 60 degree. So this will be an equilateral triangle. And the perimeter of an equilateral triangle will be the 3 into side. So one side is given 6, 3 into side means 3 into 6. 6 3 is 18. So answer will be the option number B. Now I am going to the question number 5. Question is saying that what is the perimeter of the given triangle ABC? So here two angles are given 70-70. So that means two sides will be equal. It is an isosceles triangle is given. Base is given 4 and equal sides are, one of the equal side is given 6. So another will be also 6. So 6 plus 6 plus 4. 6 4 10 plus 6 will be 16. So answer will be the option number A. Thank you.